Hello everyone, welcome to my first tutorial. So, what I'm going to show you is how to do the classic print effect I usually give to my drawings. This one is a drawing I made during Good Dog Press live stream recently. Go check it out. There are two ways to do this. One is the easy way will be to use Permanent Press by Mr. Retro. It's a plugin for Photoshop, but it costs $100. If you have the money, you can use it, and it's a really powerful tool. But if you don't want to spend the money, here is how I do it. What you need first is a big file. So this one, you can see here the resolution is 625 dpi, more than 6000 width and 9000 height. So you need a big file to do this. So what you need to do is to merge everything. So I delete the useless layers, and after this we go to image, we go to mode and go to CMYK color. Okay. So is we need to do this because what we are going to do is to first we have to this layer we have to convert to a smart object, and after that we duplicate the layer. Right. And you need to have four layers, because what we are going to do next is to go to blending options and in the channels in advanced blending, the channels section, we are going to do each layer is going to be a different channel. So this one is going to be C, which is cyan. So this one is going to be magenta. This one is going to be yellow. And this one is going to be black with is K here. So if you turn you can see each layer is now a different channel. Now what we are going to do now is to look for a paper texture. You can find paper texture on Google if you search paper texture. So select and copy. So next, what we are going to do is change the, I think it's going to be the blend mode from normal to darken to each layer. Darken. Going to change the contrast, no, the brightness on this, on the texture, the PP texture, so you can see now the picture. If we zoom in, you can see going to this texture again, we're going to convert to black and white. We're going to lower the brightness. Like this. We select and copy. And we're going to paste here on top, and this one we are going to change the blend mode to soft light. So you, if you watch closely, you can see that now the texture is over the ink. After we done this, it's time to do the halftone. So what we are going to do is go to filter, pixelate, color halftone. Now you can on max radius, you can go, but if what I usually do, go to, I set it to 4. You can set it to the size you want, but I use 4 because it's a little more subtle. So we have the yellow layer selected, and I'm going to do this on the yellow, magenta and cyan layers and not in the black layer. You can do it on the black layer, but I think it's not necessary, and it kind of blur the black too much. So we do the same thing for the rest of the layers, like I said. And you can see when I zoom in, you can see all the half tone. Of course, if you want to be more noticeable, you can go with a bigger radius. Next, what you can do, yeah, I think what I usually do, I take each of the layers of the drawing and Reduce the opacity to 90%. 90%. So, something that you sometimes, if you look closely to print pages, you're going to notice that it's not, and the colors not always, are not always perfect, perfectly aligned. So, what you can do, for instance, I have selected the cyan layer. So, with the arrow keys of the keyboard, I move the cyan key, the cyan layer on a horizontal scale to the right, and you can see how the image the cyan layer is going to the right, giving this imperfect image. I'm going to do it a little more subtle. And for instance, I can go with the yellow layer. I'm going to move it a little bit on a vertical. So I move up, I move the layer up, and you can see already here, for instance, how there is a small yellow line, and these are small details, but it gives the picture more of that printed look. So now we have done that, we merge and you can see the colors change a little bit, but it's looking good. So now what I going to do is go to mode, in image mode, I'm going to RGB color, image size, and change the resolution to 400. You can I do 400, but 300 is good enough if you want something a little smaller. 300 DPI is like enough to do a good printing. No, okay. So you can see now that how this looks. If you do this correctly, you can even fool someone into thinking that this is a real print drawing. So yes, this is I hope you enjoy this. I know I'm this is the first time I'm doing this, so I'm not good at teaching stuff to people, but I hope this is useful for you. And yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.